friends, and I am in South Kolkata catching up with a bunch of them to find out what are their hopes and aspirations and how excited they are. So have you got your voter identity card? Have you registered yourself already?
I just went yesterday for my hearing, like for the voter card hearing, and I'm quite excited to as a first-time voter. And from the government, I just want assurance. Like in 2014, we got so much assurance from BJP government, but I did not see anything coming. So whatever government forms this time, I just want them to give assurance and do their work.
I think for now we need to focus on the economic part of it. But the thing is that nobody is actually, none of the governments are actually focusing entirely on what they want to do. And that is why it is a big confusion for us first time voters, because this is the first time we'll be voting and we are so confused on like which party should we vote for. This is going to be our government for the next five years. And that is a very big decision, and for the first time only it is a big decision, and then there's so much pressure that we cannot choose. So I don't think anybody is focusing. I think they're just fighting right now. Mm-hmm. None of them are focusing on India. They're focusing on who should win.
Would you say as a young voter that India lacks a leader when it comes to opposition? That's what they are seem to be suggesting, that there is no leader, face of the opposition, which is why, you know, they want to vote for a certain political party.
Honestly, I won't say that. I find Rahul Gandhi to be a better person in like the person he was in 2014 and the person he is today. There's a very big difference. So we cannot just say that he lacks leadership. It's just about confidence and everything. But honestly, the bigger picture over here is that we as first-time voters, we are not given any type of privilege. Like, we are not even, you know, shown, like, we are not even, like, a part of the manifestos, I feel. We are nowhere. Like, no government ever talks about the youth. Mm-hmm. The government is more interested into other things than the youth, than the education.
But when it comes to youth, one of the biggest things that all political parties this time has talked about is jobs, and jobs are a big issue during this election. Do you think that's being adequately addressed or no?
I don't think so. That's happening. I think that employment is a big problem in India considering the population. And I don't think the leaders are doing anything about it. Even though they are promising since the past few years, nothing has been done. Mm-hmm. And I really don't see anything happening about it also, because there's no control of population. Mm-hmm. And the leaders are only giving us, they're like just telling us things, but nothing is really happening. So I think that is the issue that we're all facing. And that is why we're all having this confusion, especially as a first-time voter, because it's a big responsibility for us to choose someone who's actually going to help the country. But we don't know who to go for because of these problems.
Right. In the next couple of years, you know, you will probably be going out to the job market, seeking jobs. What are the kind of areas that, you know, you look for job creation in?
So there are different sectors, I think, which the government should keep focus, like creating more jobs and giving more opportunities to the youth, which like in 2014, there were lots of promises made, for fake promises, good promises, bad promises, all kind of promises. But I think promises will not do. The government has to take initiative. Like I read both the manifestos of both the party, and I saw Congress giving lots of scheme that how they are going to fulfill the 22 lakhs jobs which are empty. And then BJP also saying lots of things. But I think promises will not do. Someone has to take that initiative, and they have to tell the audience that as the first-time voters, we should know that how you're going to implement that, because making fake promises is not going to help them. And one more thing I would like to tell, as a first-time voter, we don't think that Ram Mandir should be in the manifesto of some party, because it is not something which is going to do well to the society, and it is going to be not good for some majority, some minorities. And I think the government should take everybody as an individual. There should be one country for everybody, and that should be the main motto of any party who is going to come up to make the next government.
So the first-time voters here at this institute, they are very urban and they have different aspirations, but they're just not talking about themselves. They're also talking about politics of polarization, which may not be good for India. In Kolkata, with GD Shankar, Rika Roy for NDTV.